clap. It's a huge beer mug. Okay, we've got Rooks, and we've got Lauren. Yes. Okay, how's it, Rooks?
I'm fine, self.
Very good. Now, do you make this beer?
Yes. We've got two breweries, a brew pub. Sorry.
That's right.
On a farm about 100 kilometers from here, we've got the Mogollywood restaurant and pub, which is a brew pub. And then we've got a microbrewery also at the site.
Yes.
And there we brew Bavarian style beer only. And we do mainly pilsners and ales. And then we try to drink it before anybody else gets it.
Wow.
How's Rooks, the size of this?
Those are proper beer glasses.
Yeah, look, this one, this is Hofbräuhaus. We like the Hofbräuhaus beer. There's Paulaner. These are the styles of beer we brew.
So German, really?
Bavarian, German.
Right,
sure.
Right,
and
right.
That must be yours.
They're quite, they like, not like see-through, transparent. What is the process? What is the different process of making them compared to like a normal lager?
Okay.
Let me just put it down because my arm can't handle it.
Without going too much into detail of the difference between all the beers and so on, the main difference between commercial beverages and beer is that we don't filter our beer. We brew with barley and we don't pasteurize, and therefore, and we don't use any fish products in our beer like the commercials.
Fish products?
Yeah, the normal isinglass, which is the swim bladder of the fish, is used by the commercials in the fermenting situations with...
Jeez, and I hate fish.
Well,
I'm surprised I like
fish. That, huh?
I'm surprised I like beer. It's got fish in it.
Can I just tell you one thing very quickly right
yes.
now?
Yeah.
Our show starts at 3. Not half past 3.
Which show?
Three.
Which show is that?
Afternoon show. Starts
Listen,
at 3.
Have you seen how much beer we have to drink here?
I'm warning you.
Okay. Can we have a sip?
Yeah, can we have a sip, Brooks? Can we have a sip?
Well, that is why it's here.
How come you got like half a glass?
Because this is more than enough for me.
For the ladies, yeah.
Oh, cool.
Oh, that's delicious.
Yeah, okay. So craft beer and microbrewed beer should not be clear. As soon as beer is light in color and clear, then you know it has been used with artificial products to eventually clear the beer and this and the other.
That is very good.
That is freaking nice.
I know, that's why we make it.
No, that is very, very
seriously. Hard. It's got such a lovely aftertaste.
Yeah, this specific beer we brew for the Cattleman's Deck restaurant in Wildersdrift.
Okay.
Which is called the Pilsner, Pinskauer Pilsner.
Wow. Pinskauer Pilsner.
Yeah, Pinskauer is like cattle that comes from Austria. We in the Heidi movies, you see those that looks like the Jack Russell.
Yeah.
Now, we also... farm with Pinskauers, and then the Cattleman's Deck, Mitch van der Bos there, they farm with it. But he asked us to create a beer which is a Pinskauer. It's the only cow with a beer to its name.
Oh. Pinskauer. You've got fish and cows and all sorts of whole farmyard going on in your beer.
Yeah.
Wow. Listen, I just want to know, first of all...
I've got to tell you, Fernando Alonso's on a flyer. He's on a flyer at the moment.
Not what's his face?
No, oh, Alonso goes quickest. Sorry, carry on.
So, and you don't drink this as fast as an F1
car.
You enjoy beer.
Look, last time I had one of these, it wasn't just one, it was about 7, and it was in Munich, and my legs gave up. Have you ever had that feeling?
Never.
Yeah, no, my legs, I wasn't able to get home.
It looks like Rooks is a seasoned professional.
I think so.
Yeah, I think, every morning you go to the brewery, you need to taste the fermenters. Now, if they are standing 14 of them, you need to taste 14 times. And I always say the only way to taste a beer, you go to the beer festivals and people say, give me a taster. How do you taste beer? One sip? No. You drink 20 beers and the next morning, if you feel good, that's a good beer.
That's
you
if
have
you wake
got the
up.
Very coolest philosophy I've ever heard in beer tasting. But well, now do you sell, as you say, you make some of this beer for some restaurants in Wildersdrift. Do you sell this beer? I mean, can people buy this beer?
Yeah, unfortunately, we don't bottle beer. So we only have our kegs.
Kegs.
I don't know, the camera can't see the kegs.
So it's
there.
A 25 liter.
That is a 20 liter keg.
20
it's a cooler liter. Box. We're the only ones in the country that use those.
Yes.
that is a cooler box that can stand here in the studio
self-contained,
tomorrow it will still be at least 1 degree difference than now. So we geared for festivals. We go to the craft beer festivals. We go to shows and like the outdoor expo this weekend. And so that is where you can find our beer. Or you can come to our pub at Magaliewood when we're there. Obviously today we're not there. We just lock up. We don't have watches and diaries and time schedules.
I love it.
So people can come there and then they buy the beer, but they rent the cooler.
Look, like people, the Mountain Sanctuary Park last weekend, they had a lot of mountaineers there and climbers and so on. So they come out, they pick up 7 or 10 kegs, they pay the deposits. If they, if we know the people well that we trade with, it's not necessary for deposits. But you pay a deposit and you buy the beer. And sometimes, like bigger clients or whatever and so on, we give them the beer and when they come back, they pay for what they use for the closed keg.
That's cool.
So it's like consignment.
Yeah. And you don't need taps. You don't need all the bottles and the regulators. And you don't have to clean the lines and so on. For them, it's easy. They just pick it up, have a funeral, have a wedding, bring it back, give the deposit back, charge for the beer, off you go.
Wow.
That's awesome. Mm.
I was just going to, the pouring out of the cooler over there, is it just like a normal tap cooler? You're not going to get extra froth or...
No, actually less, because there are no artificial CO2 injected into the beer. Because when you go to the fancy restaurants with the fancy taps and this and the other, 50% of the time you see the barman is struggling with the foam.
Yes.
Now, there's a scientific thing about the pressure of the beer, the pressure of the keg inside on top of the beer, and then the CO2 that you add in that. And to get the foam away, you need to put in pressure. The more pressure you put in, the more CO2 goes to beer, and it becomes like Coca-Cola and bubbly and things like that. Beer should be flat. The flatter the beer, the better the beer is. Bad beer is always overcarbonated, like a 3 bar. We carbonate, self-carbonation is on like a 0.6 of a bar. So you can see there's no bubbly, there's no full stomach tomorrow after the 10th beer. You're not going to feel that.
I must be honest, I'm not, it's very nice.
Now listen, Rooks, you guys are going to be showing and selling and doing your thing this weekend at the Outdoor Expo. Is it the first time you've done anything like this?
Look, at the Outdoor Expo, yes, it's the first time. We attended it as visitors normally. We took the opportunity on this one because our micro commercial side of the microbrewery to go in bigger like this is only available now. We've got a capacity now that we can carry to the show 4,000 beers for the weekend. Previously, we would only carry about, 600-700.
That's not going to last.
So then, like at the Josie Craft Beer Festival, at the SA on Tap, at the Cambridge Food Show, we go to those at the Kalamia Estate with the horses and so we go there. We have ability with our own beer garden to sit 500 people. We've got the benches and everything.
Fantastic.
We can bring it in. So you find with the Clooney Estate, Clooney Farm here in Kailama, when they have a charity thing, I think the 6th of July again, we will be there. We take everything, we set up, we sell, and we give them their charity side of the beer and so on.
Terrific.
So you don't need to rent tables. All that stuff is
on. Do you have ladies in lederhosen? Because I mean, if you're going to serve these beers, right, you got to get the old jugs out, and I'm not talking about the jugs the beers go in either.
Do you know the jugs carry the jugs?
You
need muscles.
Listen, have you seen some of those ladies carrying those beers?
I can hardly carry one of these, and they carry like 6 in a hand.
More.
Like 6 to 8 in a hand.
That's properly impressive.
A liter of beer that is just under a kilogram. Then these glasses must be another 400-500.
What happens if you have to burp?
That's why they built it properly, yeah.
Okay, so the Outdoor Expo happens this coming weekend at the Waterfall Estate. It's in Kailami. It's just around the corner from Kailami, really. There's a whole bunch of stuff happening. I saw pictures of snakes. I saw Gareth with lions on Twitter. I saw spiders, and then I got creeped out.
No, we just.
I just want the beer.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they're on FM, right? They can't drink on air. Cheers.
Yeah. Yeah. Cheers. Thank you so much. This is a really tasty beer.
This is really tasty.
But
this
I'm...
Cheers, Izzy. Cheers, 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 cheers.
Can you burp on there? Cheers,
cheers, cheers. No, Sasha.
Do you know there's a special song they sing in Germany when you do cheers like that?
What?
Yeah, which one is that?
Oh, I can't remember now. I was too drunk. But I sang it at the time.
Okay.
I can't believe you brought that up and you don't know what the damn song is.
I'll find it. I'll find it now.
Yeah, there's plenty of songs.
The more
you drink, the more you remember.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. In fact, when I went there, it was Italian weekend in Germany, and there were the Italians come down from Italy to Munich, and they all drink the German beer, and it was quite weird because there were tables of Italians, and I can't speak a word of Italian.
But at least the food would have been good.
No, it was all German, but the
excuse me. That's not my beer. It's the crap you had last night, though.
Sasha!
Excuse me.
And you never do that.
I know, but what goes down must come up.
Anyway, I ended up being able to speak Italian.
Did I do that out loud?
Yeah.
Oops. Yeah. Okay, so you were trying to talk Italian.
Come, play a
talking
song.
Let's. Oh, this is going to go pear-shaped. I'm going to chat here with Rooks Off Air. And 90 days old.
Matured. Yeah.
Old.
Well,
it's 28 days to brew, and then it's 52 days to wait.
Yeah, the specific one we're drinking. Because when we brew, we take like 5 days for the primary fermentation.
Yeah.
And then up
you
to
put
about
the finings.
Yeah.
Ask me.
And then... That's good. And then another
try this,
say, 21
this
days for the secondary fermentation.
Nice,
Then we drop the temperatures to get the yeast and so on to go to sleep. And then we keg them. Then they sit in our kegs for another 50, 60 days, 2 months, before they go out. Just to get proper, matured, rounded beer without that funny taste in it.
But you like that guy on Discovery, man.
Erwin, he's dead.
No. No. The guy from the shark beer place.
Dogfish.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
In the States.
There's no fish in this beer.
Yeah. No, but Dogfish, they make very good beer. And so on.
Do you also, you're a bit of a mad scientist like that, where you'll try and put anything into your beer just to see if it improves the flavor?
No.
I mean, he's putting like oak in and then chilies in and all sorts of things.
Yeah, what we do is we brew our main lines.
Yes.
And then a small brewery, which is like a 60-liter plant.
Yeah.
We do funny things. We brew with honey. We make Braggot. We make Payment. We make strawberry beer. We make Waldmeister.
Raspberry?
I don't want strawberry beer.
Raspberry beer. Yeah, raspberry beer. I don't think we haven't got a sample yet. But the chicks dig it because just when you...
Is it like a panty dropper?
Chicks dig it because it's raspberry beer.
Yeah. No, it is the pink thing. You look like fashionable, and also like the Green Mamba. You look different between the crowd and so on. And then you can drink it like water. It is still 4.5% alcohol. It is a beer. And the chicks dig it because it is not that bitter, especially after the 15, 16 beer. Then beer becomes bitter for them. Then you give them raspberry.
What?
Yeah.
Rooks, what's your alcohol content?
Mine at the moment about 95%, but the beer is
4.5. Yeah. Okay, that's good to know.
Yeah, I mean I've got a little bit of blood in my
in your alcohol system.
Yeah.
I want to ask the 90 days. So you brew, etc. After 28 days, then it sits. I assume. What does it do to before you actually?
It chills, brew.
Yeah, in a way, what?
Cock.
What do you think it's gonna do?
I don't know, but how? I mean, do you have it in a barrel? Do you have it? I don't know. What do you do?
Okay,
I don't understand.
In a fermenter, we run the first primary fermentation so that the yeast attacks
eats
the,
up sugar
and it then pisses alcohol and farts CO2. Okay.
Yes.
And after that 5 days, it is finished with the process. Now we need the beer to mature a little bit and for the yeast to sleep because there's no sugar anymore to eat.
Right.
And we, I think, one of the very few brewers that ferment out to 1002 on a gravity scale. Commercials are 105. So our beer is dry. It's without sugar. It's low in calories. But it is more bitter, but it is not that hoppy. The bitterness gives less hops, but less sugar also. then it stands for another 3-4 weeks for the yeast to sleep.
Yeah, yeah, I get it.
Okay. When the yeast then sleeps and falls to the bottom and the dead yeast is on, then we tap the clear beer out of the fermenter.
Yes.
We put it in the kegs. Then the kegs stand at 3 degrees for another month or two or three, depending on what type of beer. We don't want to sell ale, which can be sold the day after. Our ale is all already 4 weeks mature. Lagers and pilsners, 6 weeks. We push it to 8 weeks. The name lagering, like the voortrekkers pull the lager to protect themselves and so on. The beer actually stands at 3 degrees, a lager, and makes a lager and matures and become more rounded and more tasty than that green stuff that you sometimes taste.
Yes, Rooks, you can't
fault Rooks.
You can't drink your stuff while you're working, because clearly this is complicated business. This is an art.
You can, man. Once I fell in the bloody fermenter, almost drowned. But I had to climb about 6 times to piss. But then, beer is not only, beer is for all day, not only for breakfast. Before breakfast, I can't eat an empty stomach. So for breakfast, you have a porter. We make a mean black beer, porter.
Okay.
It's like coffee, chocolate taste. So you have your coffee, but in porter. Then you have your breakfast, then you taste the fermenters, this and the other. The day you brew, if it's a brew day, by 12 o'clock, then the slogging of the mixing. We are handcraft beer.
Right.
We don't have machines, we don't have stirrers, we don't have nothing. It's all made by hand.
How many beers do you make? Different beers?
Varieties.
Like you say, you got
to... To the festivals, we take like 7 different styles.
Yes.
To the outdoor expo this weekend, we've only got 2 styles.
Okay.
Drinkable, because we must compete with the castle drinkers,
Yes.
The castle drinker wants something. They always come up to me and say, "Oh, God, what tastes like castle?" I say, "Fucking luckily, nothing." Because you need...
Rooks, I love you more and more, baby.
The problem is with the South African beer culture is we don't have a beer culture.
Carry on.
Here the guys go to the braai and they pop a castle and they talk about cars and chicks and so on. In Germany, they go and they have a barbecue and they open a beer and they talk about hops and fermentation and stuff. They've got a beer culture. We haven't got a beer culture in South Africa. The Cape has got a better beer culture than up here in the north. Maybe with a wine history and this and that and so on. So, for this expo, we brought beer that is this, which is better than the commercial beers, but it's not like funny to the, it's just good drinking Bavarian beer.
That's good.
Yeah. Grows on.
But when
crashed.
You do the funny things, sometimes you just have to throw it away. People are just not used to it.
Oh, sure, I can understand that.
Yeah.
Okay, I've got a question. It might be very stupid because I don't know much
no
about
No such
beer.
Thing as a stupid question.
Stupid
but
does.
my brother bought my boyfriend a whole lot of different craft beers for his birthday. And the alcohol, like the one is so much higher in alcohol, it was something like 10%. And the guy said, "You'll sleep flat out after drinking it because it's also this big." How does that happen? Like, what makes it different alcohol levels?
Okay, the difference in alcohol level is derived by the sugar. Okay, so if we want to make a beer with, say, 13%, which is Oktoberfest beer and this and the other, then we must push up our grain amounts. Because what we do is we take the grain and we mix it, malt it with the water to derive the sugar out of that. If we want more a beer with more alcohol, we need to put more grain in. Not like some people that put sugar in, because then you make just
sugar. Artificial.
Yes.
Artificial
okay.
beer.
Okay, so you're creating the sugar from the
so
grain.
So this is 4.5%. If we want to make a 10% one in our plant, we will push our grain for the batch up to say 400 kilograms. And then we just get more sugar. Then we need a better strain of yeast, because the yeast is a very sensitive little organism. If you give it too much sugar, it actually gets frightened and it runs away. We need 2 billion cells per liter of beer to make, but when the sugar is too high, then that must be compensated for. So eventually all the sugar is eaten up by the yeast. And the more sugar you give them, the more alcohol they piss.
Yo.
Finished. That is basically, the...
How it's done. Okay, cool.
I want to meet a yeast.
The more sugar.
Why do you want to meet a yeast?
Well, I'd like to meet a yeast. Give him some sugar, piss alcohol. I don't know. I thought a yeast, you sat there and you put it in the oven and then the bread goes up.
Same thing. So they take abuse, eh?
Well, the whole thing about it is you're murdering the yeast by putting it in the oven.
Yeah.
Which, I don't know. I understand.
Yeah, look, there.
Listen, it's too technical.
Yeah. Listen, Wade Ashley on Twitter wants to know, he says here, Rooks is a legend. Can't you give him his own show on Balls, or at least a guest slot on Blades' show? A guest slot on Blades' show.
Can you imagine Blades and Rooks?
Hey, you and Hugh Bladen would team up perfectly, man.
Damn.
No, I hope so, yeah.
Yes. I don't think you'd have a business afterwards, because Blades would probably drink it all.
Nolan says, get that dude a chair, he's going to fall over.
Look, let's just quickly get down to business before we continue, Rooks, because I want to chat more. But the Outdoor Expo, it happens this coming weekend at the Waterfall Estate in Kyalami. It's a massive polo field. It's a beautiful venue, actually. Some multi-gazillionaire who's got the place, and he opened it up for a bit of an expo. But it's perfect this weekend. Weather's beautiful in winter, etc. It's nice to get outdoors. There's stuff for the kiddies to do. 55 Rand if you're an adult. To get yourself in. If you're under 17, you'll pay 10 Rand, is it? And young kids under 12, I think, get in for free. So it's as simple as that. Get yourself there. There's all sorts of outdoor goodies. There's trailers. There's a whole bunch of stuff that you can get yourself there to see. Plus, Philippa just told me a bit earlier on today that they're doing collections for rhino poaching and the people in the fight against it. So if you've got any bits and pieces that you could perhaps help out with in the fight against rhino poaching, probably money is the best thing to do. But binoculars or warm clothes or blankets or anything like that to help in the fight against rhino poaching. There are several stands which will be there this weekend. So make your way there. Doors open at 9 a.m. in the morning and close at 5 p.m. It's this coming Saturday and Sunday, the Outdoor Expo at the Waterfall Polo Estate in Kyalami. Make sure that you get there.
All right, 21 Balls Visual Radio, our special guests, all to do with the Outdoor Adventure Show, which is taking place at Waterfall
Estate. Name changes every time we say it. First it's the Outdoor Expo, then it's the Outdoor Adventure Show.
It's outdoor, it's at Waterfall Estate, just down the road from
it's
where we are.
It's the Outdoor Expo.
Outdoor Expo, just down
and
the road.
And on Twitter, Outdoor Expo 1.
Outdoor Expo 1.
Number 1.
Now listen,
don't worry about the beer on the carpet.
We've got this terrific master beer brewer, Rooks. Who's here?
And he's hammered.
And he makes a tremendous amount of different beers, but he's made this one specifically for this outdoor expo and for us specifically.
Yeah.
And it's an extraordinary beer. I must be honest. Besides the fact that I'd just love to sit and talk a couple of hours with Rooks. No, I'm fine. Thank you very much. That's actually.
I filled up, eh?
Yeah.
And I have to drive. You only drive a little machine with it.
Exactly. I'm driving. What time's Darren's show start?
It's strange. I thought a Ferrari looked like a bit like a little machine with red and yellow knobs as well.
Yeah. No. Now the thing is, you make this beer, as I say, and you sell it. Is this a profitable concern for you? Or is it a passion?
It's a passion. You need to have a passion. Look, the micro brewery thing like exploded. We are
doing so well.
6 years ago, we were 8 recognizable brewers. Today, we are 55.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's a lot in the Cape, and there's one in the Free State. Natal's got a lot, but Joburg is picking up. There's application for 11 new licenses around the Hartbeespoort Dam alone. So it's picking up. But if you want to make money, you must open a topless car wash, because beer does not really make money.
That's a good idea, Rooks.
Yeah.
Can we not attach your brewery to the topless car wash?
And wash with beer.
No.
Yes. Now we're talking here. Yeah.
Just take the foam and then it looks like it's bubbly. Yeah.
Voila, you've got it. But I can't see a parking area outside where you can put it up and spray beer and open a window and drink water, wash and stuff. No, it would be great. No, What I'm saying is, yeah, there is obviously in it, but your licensing regulations and so on, it's not difficult. It's all there. You go through that. Then you register with your SARS warehousing. We pay excise duties on tax or excise duties on runabout. At the moment, it's 57 Rand a 100% alcohol, liter of alcohol that we manufacture. So it's like 3 Rand a liter of beer goes there. And so eventually, when you add up all your malt and all your labor and whatever, then especially where we are 100 kilometers out of the city, transportation here and there, it is a cutthroat business in a way. But it is probably one that is the fastest growing. And the way I see people now carrying in, buying equipment and so on, 3 years or 4 years from now, you're going to have a lot of second-hand plants for cheap to buy. Then you start this. Because if you don't have passion, it's not going to work. It will just land up next to the exercise bicycle in front of the porch in the garage. Finished. You need to brew. You need to wake up in the night to check the fermentation, see what's happening, the temperatures. Automatic plants are easy. You just press buttons and you go and sleep. But brewing by hand, making craft beer with a passion, it's like a 24-hour job. Luckily, every time in the night you get up, you check the yeast, have a sip, still there.
This is the most passionate guy. Yeah. It's just so fantastic to meet somebody who really, and who makes a damn fine beer, I must just tell
you. Now, Rick, so you're going to give a talk at the Outdoor Expo? Because it's too good to not have you have a talk there.
I don't know if there's any opportunities there. Yeah. We open. Anybody can come to me and talk beer and this and that and so on. Unfortunately, we like tucked away 2 stands away from the beer seating area. But people check us out and come and talk to me. If there's any, you're not going to be there live transmission. So
no, unfortunately not. Not this time. No.
But this and the other. Yeah. If there's opportunity, we sometimes use some of the artists like Daniel Barron. We see him at about every festival. Then he promotes us. He's crew.
Cool guy,
we know
each
other. Yeah, he's a great guy. He likes a beer. Though he's not a big beer drinker, but some of his crew members are good drinkers. Yeah, and we can talk about it. Yeah, what I wanted to say about. You know, being a brewer or a doctor, you know, doctors bury their mistakes. We drink them.
Wow. That one's just for you, Maz. Both her mom and dad are doctors.
Oh, that's funny.
Yo, okay.
So all right, cool.
Yeah, I've never tasted a bad beer.
No, sure. I mean, sure.
Rick, listen. I have. I'll be honest. I have. I've tasted some bad beers.
Yeah, but if there's an option or another beer, then you don't have to drink that one. But if you're in the middle of the desert and it's the only shit beer, you drink it.
I know, that'll
not
be
bad.
That'll be a great beer.
It's a great beer if it's the only beer.
Have you actually been in that situation?
I was at Yaoundé Airport a couple of years ago, and I was like, I like the African beer, especially the Congo beers and so on. The tanks are so old, you can taste the iron in it. It's like iron brew, the elephant beer and stuff like that. But in Yaoundé, that's the Cameroon, the old Belgian Cameroon, they make reasonable good beer. But on the airport, there was just no beer, nothing. And I saw there was a little fridge with some South African exported commercial beer in it. And I said, and I just needed a beer. I said to the guy, give me one of those. And I tilted the bottom because, you know, you can see from the bottom of every beer the time it was bottled or canned, which line, which time, whatever. And I saw this beer is like 4 years old. And shelf life of commercial beers, export beers, maybe a year if it's brewed and prospecting. Normal beer, 12 weeks. This is like 4 years old. Open it. It's still... Pour it in, it's like dark and the haze factor is out of the beer and so on, but it was still better than the water.
Oh, I love this guy.
Me too.
All right, Rich, Listen, we'll give you a website out from on Facebook in a couple of seconds from now. We'll let you know we can hook up.
From Boston and Black Jack, I think. Yeah, I'm not 100% sure, but I think it's more than Jack Black.
Yep.
He asked us to go, but some other commitments. So at least they're starting to a little bit. And then in Pretoria and Capital Beer Festival on the 6th of July, we weren't invited so far, only the Cape. How do you have Cape Brewers in Pretoria and you call it the Capital Brewery? I don't know. Microbrewers is like now tearing each other apart. They must stand together. We don't have more than 0.09% of the market. If we grow like we're growing now, in 20 years, we'll have 2% of the market.
I mean, it's not...
But it's
not as though you're a big threat. You're just trying to do something with passion.
Yeah.
Slightly different way of doing things.
With a passion, yeah. So Man vs. Beer is there for all the brewers, all the people that's passionate of beer, to get involved, see where the craft is, see where the beer is, ask questions, and get involved in everything.
Okay, that's a good one. Man vs. Beer, it's on Facebook. You can go and type it in there. MANVSBEER, Man vs. Beer. Simple as that. Good, Rooks, thank you so much for joining us today. Don't forget the Outdoor Expo takes place at Waterfall Polo Estate this coming weekend. 55 Rand for adults, 10 Rand for kids under 17, and children get in for free, basically. It happens Saturday and Sunday. Doors open at 9 a.m. and it goes right through until 5 p.m. Rooks will be there along with a whole bunch of unbelievable things happening. If you're an outdoorsy type person, go check it out for yourself. Thanks for the beer, man.
No, yeah, thank you very much. So much. That was divine.
You want another one?
No, I'm good, thanks. Never drunk a liter of beer like that in my life. Anyway, listen, so that's us. Have a lovely day.
Are we going now?
Yeah, we're going now. No, we can't do what you did last time.
That was fine.
Did you see how stern he was?
He was very stern. See, Scotty's sitting and even he's shaking his head. No, you can't do that because you're going to get in trouble.
Nobody gave him a beer? No, Scotty doesn't drink.
Scotty does drink.
I've never seen
Peter Manowick said, how can we get hold of some Rooks beer in Cape Town?
Go to Beer versus Man.
Move to Joburg.
We'll be there in September at my son's wedding and we'll take beer down.
There you go.
All right.
There we go.
Peter, because we've got Philippa here, we will ensure that somehow we get some beer to you in Cape Town.
Hey, listen, we've got tickets to give away. If you'd like to come to the Outdoor Expo this weekend.
Come to the Outdoor Expo. It's in Waterfall Estate.
Okay, so here's the question. All you need to do is answer this question. Where is the Outdoor Expo happening this weekend?
Yeah.
You can tweet the answer to Outdoor Expo 1.
Outdoor Expo 1. All right, tweet it to Outdoor Expo 1, and you can win yourself a ticket to go to the expo.
Two tickets.
Listen, have a great afternoon. Enjoy. We'll catch you tomorrow right here at 12 o'clock. Take care. Ciao, ciao.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.